You know what? I'm not leaving. I'm not leaving. I'm not f***ing leaving! The show goes on! This is my home! They're gonna need a f***ing wrecking ball to take me out of here!
One and recording. Oh s***. Okay. Make sure my phone is on silent, of course. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode here on Above Average. Holy crap, it's been a second. I'm back. So is my mustache. I hope you like the intro to that video there. Guys, we got a good one today. And if you're clicking on this video, if you're new to the channel, as always, feel free to leave a like and subscribe. It's been a second since I said that, but boy, am I glad to be back. I'm not gonna lie, you can probably hear. Okay, so I've got some explaining to do. Not gonna lie, I'll make this quick, but life's been busy, man. I've been working lots, and I'm not gonna lie, I owe it to you guys to be better and to be uploading more, and I'm not gonna lie, like, I'm sorry, I really do apologize, and so I'm trying to get on this, you know, consistent schedule, but I couldn't have picked a worse week. I got sick, and I'm still going through the colds right now. Like, if you can probably hear, I'm still getting better is what I'm getting at, but so yeah, I'm sorry about that. That's the main reason why you haven't seen me. I had no energy to record or to edit. I literally just laid in bed, and then yeah, so I'm sorry about that. I will be better. Oh, like, I am sorry. I need to upload. You know, you guys have been amazing, and so I need to, you know, pick it up on my end. So I am sorry. I really wanted to say that, but we got a great one for you today. If you're new to the channel, my name is Trevor, and yeah, last video I guess I did, I just want to quickly say this. We did with the BPs I worked at, we had a little game night, I guess. You know, if anyone that came to Kingsway Boston Pizza and said Above Average, they got 15% off on their meal. Well, ladies and gentlemen, happy to say few people actually ended up coming by. Was not expecting that. Those videos I uploaded were pretty like last second, and they didn't do as good as other videos. So I was like, I don't know if I'll get anyone out there. But I had quite a few tables actually, you know, come in, and like I got a text. I remember I was drinking, and I wasn't working that night, but I was drinking. I got a text, and people were like at work, like saying, Trevor, people want to meet you. Like, they came by. I'm like, so if you guys are one of those guys, oh man, I just want to say thank you, like, from the bottom of my heart. That is sick as balls. You guys showed up, and I mean, that's what I'm saying. I owe it to you guys to be uploading more, and I'm feeling better now, so that is good. But oh man, it meant the world to me, so I really do appreciate that. That was just so sick. So thanks again for that. And yeah, it was pretty cool. So we might be doing something a little bit more. We might you know, pick a specific game once a month, and maybe, you know, just fill up the bar as much as possible, and have a great night at you know, watching the Oilers hockey. So that would be dope if we could do that again, guys. And let's get it rowdy. Let's spread the word. I'll let you know the next time when we can figure that out, because that would be sick. Honestly, it really would be. But enough about that. That's like the longest intro I've done. We're talking, let's get to the matter of the hand. We're talking hockey, obviously. We're the hockey channel. And boy, there's a lot that went down this last week. And and that's the thing. There's so much I wanted to talk about. Marner's streak, you know, obviously Ovi's chasing greatness still. And, you know, Tage Thompson and Jason Robertson are two players I really want to talk about. So during that time, I said, let's just condense that into one little video. So that's where we're going to do a little recap, weekly recap of what's going on, what I missed, and what you need to know. So to start things off, Ovi's chase continues. Man, this is sick. How satisfying was that? He was able to actually get a hat trick to get 800 goals, man. So he's got one now to tie Gordie Howe, Mr. Hockey, and he's got two to pass. Obviously, it's probably going to happen. And when can it happen, you ask? Well, tomorrow against, yeah, so December 19th against Detroit Red Wings. That'll be a good one. Will he do it? Leave a comment down below. I think he will, 100%. Man, what a beauty. It was just unreal to see. So he's still lighting the lamp. It's great to see. And yeah, I just wanted to quickly talk about that. It was pretty cool. As you can see, these three goals here, just wide open, you know, in his office pretty well, right in front of the net. And it looks sick. It was so cool to see. So here's hoping he gets it, and he could get it tomorrow night. Leave a like for Ovi if you like. If you like Ovi, let's go, baby.
It's yours, boys and girls and babes. Let's go! Oh!
Your let's go boys and girls and babes. I just seen that the other day and it totally just made me chuckle. I seen that, just an all-time quote from Alexander Ovechkin. How he said it, just still, he's just so liquored, right? But anyway, so that was sick. Let's go boys and girls and babes. But next up, Tage Thompson and Jason Robertson, the two up-and-coming American players that just really came out of nowhere, both kind of sleeper picks, like not like high-end picks, like they were early round. Like I know Jason Robertson was like 50th overall or something like that. I forget where Tage Thompson was selected, but oh, first round, 26K. So I was wrong. So he was a first round pick, and I mean, I guess that's, you can kind of tell now because he's unreal. Like both those guys, Tage Thompson right now is currently sitting third in the league scoring with 49 points, and Robertson is fifth with 46 points. What these guys have been able to do for their teams is like been insane. Like they're the engines. They're pretty well running the offense. Jamie Benn was doing nothing this year. They put him on with Jason Robertson, and now he's starting to contribute. You know, those guys are, you know, the saying, like those like great players make other players good, and it's because like they don't have to rely on anyone but themselves. They're generating their chances like by themselves. And Tage Thompson, I mean, what can you say? Like, what can you not say at this point? He is just lighting it up. And I did call it, like I did a video like maybe about a month ago, over a month ago, saying Tage Thompson is literally going to be probably the next, like I think, dude, all trending upwards. Like he could literally be like the first, he could be the best American player in the NHL within like the next 2 years. Like that's how high I see him being, better than Matthews. And a lot of people might disagree with that, and it is a pretty bold take, but dude, I just, his ceiling is just continuing. He hasn't stopped, and like it's been lights out. He's a highlight reel. Like he's got that X factor, and it's so sick to see. Like he's easily become like probably my he's my favorite player like outside of the Oilers right now this year. I think like Tage Thompson is that sick, and it's so cool to see. But Jason Robertson, no slouch in his own right. Like he's just crushing it. 23 goals, 23 assists, good enough for 46 points this year. I was very blown away with this personally. I do not think, like, you know, just for an example, so Jason Robertson, he signed very late. I don't know if you guys remember, but he was like one of the last signings for an RFA this year. I think he signed like maybe a week before. I think he missed all training camp, and a lot of players have a hard time with that. And two examples I'm going to bring up, most recent examples, why I hate when it's like last second deals to get the season, because I don't think they work, but it's working within Jason Robertson case. So maybe it does work every now and then. But William Nylander, he kind of did the exact same thing, right? He held out for quite a bit, and the year that he ended up signing the contract that he has right now, I think it was like 2-3 years ago now, but 2018 when he signed that maybe, and dude, it was his worst year. He was just sucking the sack all year. He wasn't doing anything crazy, and so Exhibit A, that's a pretty good example right there. But if not him, also Elias Pettersson. It was 2 years ago, him and Quinn Hughes both kind of held back. I'm pretty sure it was him and Quinn Hughes. They held out to like last second to sign their contracts. And Elias Pettersson, man, he missed training camp, I remember, and he just was really not having a great year that year. And so when Jason Robertson signed and he was like holding out, I was like, man, like that's really too bad. Like he's going to have a down year. I couldn't have been more wrong. Like he's just proving me wrong, and he's looking like an absolute beauty. Like both those guys, like, man, American hockey players, like I want to do a video on that pretty soon. If you guys think that would be interesting, like definitely leave a like and a comment, because it's just insane. Like, you know, Canada was, you know, the powerhouse for hockey, but I'm telling you, like Team USA's roster now, like you look at the top 10 scorers right now, and a good chunk of them are Americans. And even like the top 20, top 30 scorers in the NHL, Brady Tkachuk, you look at Jack Hughes, obviously Jack Eichel's picking up, you got Austin Matthews, but like just the players that have really come up out of nowhere recently, it's pretty insane. And it's kind of scary, but whatever. So wanted to talk about those two players. On to the next thing. And what are we talking about? We're talking about Mitchell Marner, and this is dope. Mitch Marner's crazy streak happened to come to an end, and I really wanted to dedicate a video on him, but obviously I got sick, so I didn't. But I still have to talk about this now, man. Like, what a beauty. Like, he very well could be the best player. If any Toronto fans are watching, I'd love to hear your thoughts. But is he not the best player in Toronto right now? Is he better than Matthews? Like, are they, like, they're very different players. Obviously, you got a dynamic, both dynamic players, but in their own right, like, he's a playmaker, and Matthews, obviously, is the sharpshooter, the goal scorer. But I don't know, man. I think Marner, he drives his offense maybe a little bit more. He's a playmaker. He can also, you know, he can also shoot the puck pretty well. But I think at the end of the day, like, who do you take? The better goal scorer or the better, you know, all-around player? Like, Marner is going to get more points than Matthews, I think, on any given year, really. So, I don't know. I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts, and I was kind of wanting to do a video on that as well. So I might still do that, but let me know in the comments below. But yeah, man, Marner, absolute beauty. It was so sick to see. Just so cool. Him and Jason Robertson's, they both extended their point streaks. I think that was like at the 19 game mark, but still pretty cool to see, man. And he's not slowing down. He was able to get 31 points, 11 goals, 20 assists in that 23 game point streak. So pretty cool. He breaks a franchise record, notching career high, 21 game point streak, which breaks a previous record that was held by Daryl Sittler in 1977 and 78 and Eddie Olchuk in 89-90. So pretty cool that he was able to break that, and not bad at all. So that's pretty well all I got for Mitchell Marner. You know, obviously he had an unbelievable run. I think it's the third best run in the modern or in the salary cap era. I think Crosby's in 2010, he had like a 25 game, and then Patty Kane was at 28, and that was my grad year. I think it was 2015-16. So pretty insane, but that's all I got for Mitch Marner. On to the next thing. And what are we talking about? You gotta talk about the Oilers. Obviously, I hadn't uploaded a video in a week. I gotta talk about my Oilers. So it's still a roller coaster. We're still, you know, kind of doing okay. Not gonna lie, I was actually at the game where we lost. It was yesterday, Anaheim Ducks in Edmonton. Just got it. Riley, if you're watching this, you're an absolute beauty. I had such an unreal time. Literally, it was a long day. I did drink quite a bit, but it was fun. It was good drinking. We got Sportsnet Lounge. Like, are you kidding me? We got tickets to the Sportsnet Lounge. It was so dope. We go in there, and my buddy Riley tells me, he's like, yeah, like, I'm pretty sure we can eat anything here. Like, the only thing we have to pay for is the drinks. And I was like, are you serious? Sign me up. So literally the whole game, every time we sat down in intermissions, my plate's just so full. Like, people are like looking at me like, holy crap, like, that guy must be struggling. But no, man, the food was unreal. It sucks they lost. I was as rowdy as I usually was? Not gonna lie, I contained myself quite a bit. I had to be on good behavior because there's like families here. It was so funny. Anaheim scored their first goal. I'm like, "F you!" I yelled it so loud. Oh, it was pretty embarrassing. I'm like, like, I'm not in the nosebleeds, you know, there's kids around. I'm like, I'm double fisting with my drinks. I'm like, I gotta settle down. So, you know, it was a great day. We had a great time. We, you know, catching up with a buddy I haven't seen in so long. It was pretty sick. But as for the Oilers, yeah, we freaking lost. It sucked. You know, we couldn't do anything, man. Like, I swear, it's these bottom feeder teams that just bend us over time and time again. Man, I've said it before, and I'll say it again. We just make those like four string goalies look like Vezina Trophy winners, like the Brodeurs, the Prices of the world. It doesn't make sense, man. I didn't even, my buddy, he was like, "Who's in net?" And I'm like, "Is Gibson?" I think Gibson. He's like, "No, like, who's that guy?" And I like looked. I'm like, "Never heard that guy in my entire life." Of course, he bends us over. So that sucked. As for, you know, some of the players, Stu, for the most part, he's been consistent. Obviously, his numbers have dipped a little bit to start the season, which was to be expected, right? He's not going to be rocking that one, or 940 save percentage, or 950 it was. We knew it would drop, but he's still giving us a chance every single game. So Stu, let's go. Let's keep those stashes going, bro. This is for you. And we're not playing the worst, but we're definitely not playing, you know, the best either. So, and as of right now, I really think it just boils down to our injury woes. We've been going through quite a bit. Obviously, Kaner's out. Yamo, he just came back. He's looked decent. Fogle's out. Ryan McLeod's out. And then as of today, Philip Broberg and Ryan Murray are out for at least over a month. And then obviously you got Kane out for at least two more months. So it sucks, but that's pretty well all the Oilers. Connor and Leon are still tearing it up. 1-2 in league scoring. Let's go. Noish. Nothing too shabby about that, but enough about the Oilers. We're finishing on a high note. And man, I can't believe it's already that time of the year. World Juniors, less than a week away. Leave a like just immediately for that. I don't know about you guys, but that's honestly one of my favorite things about hockey. Obviously, that's like, it's literally every kid's dream to be repping Team Canada jersey, playing for Team Canada in the World Juniors. I don't know about you, but like, That's all I did. Like, I fantasized that when I was younger. I'm like, that's going to be me one day. Obviously, it never happened. And here I am. But it's pretty sick, man. So that's my favorite time of the year. Brady, who I do the show with, him as well. It's pretty cool. And I love, like, looking back at videos or just games from like 5 years ago, and you're like, oh yeah, like that's who that was, and he's in the NHL now, he's on the Oilers or something like that, right? Like, it's just, it's crazy. And it's you know, it's like college basketball, it's like March Madness. So that's the equivalent to that, right? So it is so sweet. And I've actually already got, I just wanted to tee this up, but I already got, I pre-recorded a video for the World Juniors. I'm gonna be reviewing their roster. It looks so sick this year. Obviously, they got more lone players from the NHL this year than they have in like almost 20 years, I think I've seen. It was like in the 2000s was the last time they got like four, I think, because Dylan Gunther, a few other players, but it's going to be sweet. I recorded, pre-recorded that. I'm going to be giving you my thoughts on the official roster. It's going to be dope. And Connor Bedard, Shane Wright, like, let's go. We have a really, really great team this year, and I cannot wait to see what they're able to do. So that is sick. But guys, oh, thank you. I just want to say thank you. If you're watching this, if you got it this far, please just leave a like, subscribe, and just listen to me from the bottom of my heart. Thank you. Literally, it's been a tough go here, and I just want to say thank you for like all the support. You know, I was sick. I hadn't been uploading, and you can still hear it in my throat. I sound like, oh God, I sound so bad, but whatever. The show must go on, folks. So yeah, but I promise I will be better. You guys deserve it. You guys have just been, you know, helping out this channel so much for the last, you know, like year, really. This year has just been such a great growth year for the channel. And here's for many more. So, but it all starts with you guys. So let's keep the thumbs, keep on liking the videos, keep on subscribing, tell a friend, show your mom, show your aunt, auntie and uncle. You know, let's tell them about Above Average. If they haven't heard of it, they will one day, okay? So I just want to say thank you, and I will be better. I'm like Will Smith in his apology speech in Hancock.
You deserve better from me. I can be better. I will be better.
All right. I will be better. I owe it to you guys. You know, that's what I do. But it's honest to God. I do mean that, because you guys are just crushing it. And lastly, to the people that did show up at Kingsway Boston Pizza, hope to meet you one day. If we do it again, I'd love to have you guys and just talk with, you know, all of you. It was so sick. I can't believe I actually had people come in. So that like made my year. Really, it did. You have no idea how cool that was for me. I'm sorry I didn't get to meet you. Oh, meet you. Holy shit. I'm sorry I didn't get to see you, but I promise we'll do it again, and hopefully I'll get to see you then. So take her easy, guys. Let's go Oilers. Let's go Team Canada. It's a great time for hockey right now. Best time of the year. Let's go. I'll see you in the next one. And peace.